We're going to move on now to our next student, 16-year-old Patrick Hurd from Bettendorf High School in Iowa, and he has a question about the exclusionary cost of college. Patrick?
Yes, thank you for having me, and I'm very thankful to be able to represent Iowa. So my question was, what impact does rising college tuition have on young students like me to successfully and accurately plan for their future? And furthermore, what does a college degree do if college graduates are getting higher paying jobs, but they're riddled with debt?
Absolutely. Saha, what are your thoughts? Is it worth it?
Yeah, this is a great question, Patrick, and I really appreciate it. You know, it's a huge issue. College tuition costs have risen 25-30% over the last 10 years. You know, I would start by saying that I do believe the walls of credentialism are starting to crack, meaning the idea, which was once absolute, that you had to get a college degree in order to get a successful job and take care of your family and friends, is starting to break down at the slightest bit. You're starting to see companies looking past just a piece of paper and looking to the hard skills that you're developing. And you're starting to see alternatives pop up that allow you to develop those skills in a different context other than a four-year college institution. So I would encourage young people to look at all of their options as they think about what comes after high school. That being said, if you are going the traditional college route, as I did, think about the ROI, think about the return on the investment of what you're putting in and what you're investing in that education. Look into the jobs, the degrees that are getting you the highest paying jobs on the back end of it, and make sure that you're doing that research as you go in so that you know what you're going to get out of it.
And there we have our youngest student who's joining us today. Colin Marquez is an eighth grader at Diamond Canyon School. And Colin, can you go ahead with your question?
Hi, thank you so much for having me. So my question is, why do students have to learn so many things in math that they can never apply to the real world? Instead, should we be learning more things that focus on financial literacy? For example, in the JA program, we learn many things that have to do with finances. But in our everyday math classes, we learn things like algebra that we can never use. So should students focus more on financial literacy in the classroom?
I love this kid.
I mean, Sahil, you know, I have two teenagers that are taking math right now in the room next door, and they're very interested in the answer to this question too. You've been building your following on Twitter. You kind of really kind of break down finance topics in such an understandable way. What do you think should happen here?
You know, first off, I think this is an awesome question. I can hear Akbar laughing in the background. I feel the same way. I mean, it wasn't that long ago that I was in your shoes, buddy. And I felt like, look, I'm learning about isosceles triangles and the Ming Dynasty and all sorts of geometry and all those problems, but I'm not learning about budgeting. I'm not learning about taxes. I'm not learning about investing. I'm not learning about all these things that are so important for wealth creation, for supporting my family and friends and taking care of them and taking care of my life in the way I want to. So I think this is one of the great travesties of our current education system, and it needs to change. We need a national mandate around financial literacy in schools. There needs to be a basic level of learning on these topics that kids get. And look, we need to do it in a way that is different. We need to do it in a way that kids can absorb, that is digestible for them, that's accessible. Kids are surrounded by content. I mean, there's everything. There's TikToks around you, Netflix, you have all these different shows, all the movies, everything's coming at you. Kids' attention spans are different. We can't just go back to the traditional ways of textbook learning, problem sets to learn about these things. We need to deliver the information in a way that kids can absorb, and it needs to change.